Good morning. I welcome you all to the series of lectures on internal combustion engines. Today we are going to discuss about combustion induced swivel chambers. Under that, second one is air seal chamber. The first one is pre-combustion chamber that we discussed in the last class. In air seal chamber, so this is the cylinder head, cylinder, fuel injector, and the minor cell, major air cell. See, and this is the main combustion chamber. During compression stroke, the air is entering into the minor cell and major cell through the small size of orifices. So, at the end of compression stroke, the fuel injector injects the fuel across the combustion chamber so that the air and fuel will bond in the minor cell. That means the pressure rises takes place in the minor cell. Partial pressure rise takes place, and this high pressure air, comma, fuel and products of combustion, after partial combustion products of combustion come, these products of combustion and air and fuel come to the main combustion chamber, and the remaining combustion continue in the main combustion chamber itself as in the case of pre-combustion chamber. But what happened, you know, once the combustion initiate it, and the combustion takes place and piston starts move downward during expansion stroke, at that situation in the minor cell the pressure is reduced. Once the pressure in the minor cell reduced, the air which is there in the major cell, that is also transferred to the major cell. The air which is there in the major cell, that is also transferred through the orifices into the main combustion chamber, and the combustion is completed. So that is how air chamber is working. So the information here is the fuel injector is located in the main combustion chamber. See, main combustion chamber. It injects the fuel across the main combustion chamber towards the air cell. Towards the air cell, it will inject the fuel. The first ignition starts near the neck of the minor cell. The first ignition starts near the neck of the minor cell here, where the pressure rises sharply. Immediately pressure rises. This results in outflow of air. That means once the pressure rises, outflow of air, burning gas, products of combustion, that means, and the fuel to the main chamber. That means the products of combustion, air and fuel entering into the main chamber. Gas, burning gas to the main chamber from the minor cell. The outcoming gases create a strong double rotary motion. See, the outcoming gases from the minor cell create a double rotary motion in the main chamber as shown in the figure. Okay. As the combustion proceeds in the expansion stroke, the pressure in the minor cell falls. The pressure in the minor cell reduces. Once the pressure in the minor cell reduces, the major cell also discharges its air into the main chamber. So that means already air is there in the major cell, and that air is also discharged into the main chamber. The remaining combustion takes place in the main combustion chamber itself. So that means the most of the combustion takes place in the main chamber itself, but only air cells are utilized to send the air when it is needed. Thank you very much.